Okay, gonna just show you how to do a component drawing. And what I have here is a Lego leg. And it's a part that I brought in to actually create an assembly. So first things first, open the part up that you want to make the drawing of. Then go to File, and it says Make Drawing from Part. And you get this window. Press OK, then you should be given options on what paper size to put it on. Now I always tend to work on A3, and I do have my own box. I don't know why every time I start doing this Arthur wants to bark, but anyway, there's A3, and just click OK, and it actually will bring in that format for you, and it also brings in, as you can see, the file heading there. On the right hand side here, you have all of this, all the parts laid out in different ways. Now I'm going to start with this view here. So just click on it and hold it, and then just bring it in. And it will come in with a default sheet size. Okay, let go and it's dropped. Blue box on the outside, I just move to the left. It gives me that side view. If I go to the right, it gives me the back view. If I go to the top, it gives me that view and the bottom view. So it actually does all the views for you. However, if I wanted to do a fourth view on here, which will be the opposite to this one, which I do need to do, you have to press the escape button and just click on that box so it's highlighted, and then go up to drawings and then go projective view, and you can see it swaps it way around for you. And also, if you go up at 45 degrees, it gives you other ones as well that you can use to actually instruct people on how to do stuff. Now Arthur, I'm trying to teach, so please put your line away and allow me to do what I'm intending to do. So that is the basics there of that. You can also put in auxiliary views as well, but we don't need that for the moment. When you've got these views, what you'll notice is the first one you put down actually dictates the layout of the rest of them. That there is, I think, the scale. I'll tell you, scale is 5:1 at the moment, so it's 5 times as big as it should be. And you can alter those scales. You just need to click into the box. Okay, and if I do the main one and I go up to here and say use custom scale, I can go down to something like 2:1, much smaller, it does them all. I just control Z that because I like my 5:1. I'll just take it back up to 5:1. Okay, or I can click on this box here and that box and just make those I don't know what sheet scale is, it's actually marked on the paper. Let's try the sheet scale. Oh, that is 5:1. Okay, it's just click and click, hold the shift key down if you want to select more than one. And let's go your custom scale. Let's just reduce those down. 5:1. Okay, it's not in that. I'm gonna put in 4:1. Okay, and it just takes them down that slight bit as well. And I can, again, move those about as I want to. I can also highlight on those and actually change the color of them itself. It says heat. No, it's not gonna let me do it. Try one of them. Yeah, there we go, you do it one at a time. I just love it when I do something and it doesn't do as I want it to do, but hey, that's all part of it. So I've got their two parts on there. Now, with drawing, you should, it's as quick as that. I like to work off center lines, but you need sort of data and points. So if I'm going to go do some measurements, so let's just do some more overall. So don't forget, it's a component drawing, so I do need to do just about everything. And I can also do cutaways as well. So I'm just going to move this away up there before I start dimensioning. Okay, and you go up to section view. Okay, and that section view just allows me to jot. So I'm going to go midway there and give it a green tick. I can do part section tool, and I'm just going to drop that over there so you can see the actual cutaway, and it obviously sections it up for you, which is probably good enough. So now I'm going to go to view layout, sorry, annotation, go to smart dimensions, and I'm going to start to dimension the part. So I'm going to start with this one here. Just click on the line on there, and these are very odd dimensions for this part. I'm just giving that an overall part there, and you can see it does actually snap two parts for you. That looks right for me at the moment. I should probably have done that on the top one actually. So I'm just going to go back, delete that, and let's do that again. So smart dimension. Go from the top. If you can't select a line, then do find a point. If I go from there, 7.8. Okay, let's go in this center one, let's mark a radius there, 3.5. And what I'm going to do, you can also see, put center mark in, just click on center mark. If I do that, I get a center mark in this. That gives me a datum point to measure. Now Arthur's got all his toys off out of the box. So I'm actually going to use this side as my datum reference. So I'm going to go back to my smart dimensions, and I'm going to go from there to the center, and I'm going to put that down there at 3.5. I'm then going to go from there to that point there, and I say Arthur, thank you. It's not the best way to do videos with a dog trying to play with you on there. And the last one I can do for time being is from there to the outside one there, which is about there. Now, you probably also notice it looks a little bit messy. So what I can do is actually pick up on that, put that there. Let's put that one there. And put that one on there. That's the dog, not me, by the way, squeaking. I can bring this one down as well a little bit. So just try and keep it nice and clean. Back to my smart dimensions. And I'm going to go from there to that point there. And I'll bring that over to here. I'll stick it up there. Whatever format you actually use, keep it consistent. So if you use it in one place, use it in every place. And like I said here, I'm going to do that to there. And rather than not cross the drawing, I'm going to stick that there. So that is the basic sort of side elevation sort of dimensions. I'm going to do the same on this here, because what you'll notice is this little step out. So I could either do it on that one there, but I don't want to confuse too much. I can't see it on that one. No, you wouldn't see it on that one. You do see it on that one actually, but it doesn't make any sense. So what I'm going to do is click on there. That gives me an overall dimension. Stick it to the side there, and I should do that there to that there, and I'll do the top one there, and I'll stick it to the side up there. So there's only 0.2 in that. There's not really much else I need to do on that there. Apart from put my whole parameters in, still in dimensions, I know what the outside is, so I'm just going to go for the inner circle there, and it's 2.22, and that is a little chamfer on the outside, so I don't need to mark that one up. This one here is a little bit more complex. What I don't have is actually the depth of that hole, and I can do that by making one of these translucent. So the same as I did these up here, if I just go on to that there and go up to my box and just do that, I've actually got my hidden lines showing just in that box there, which is quite nice. So first things first, I'm actually going to put a diameter on that one. Okay, and I could say that's equal. That top one needs, that's interesting because it's put a radius because the whole diameter is there. But I could say in my notes that they're equal. I also now want to use my base here as a datum line, and I am going to go to that line there. More just as double checks. I will go, and again, I'm starting to run out a little bit of room. So I'm just going to pull that over to there and pull this one over. It lets me pull that over there a little bit. And I'm going to pull that one out there. Stick that up there for now. Okay. And I just want to find the centers of these circle. Just click on that bar. Okay. Smart dimension. From there to there. Okay, so I know that's 4 millimeters. I can stick that side. And I know that from there. Okay, there's no center mark in that one there. So what I can do, again, is go to my center mark tool, find the outside, clicking, I've got it. So that now gives me, okay, a line to go to. That's that one there. Now you'll notice that's a little bit squiffy. So I'll just drop it there for a second. And pick up on that one. I'm going to bring that in and bring that one into there. It sort of snaps in. After me saying try and keep it consistent, this one's a little bit more difficult. So what I'm going to do, I'll drop that side. I'll drop that down to there. Just move that on a little bit. Okay, and I'll drop this one down there, just so everything to that there is in relation to that. Now, because I've sort of started left with datums there, I'm going to stick with this. And I'm actually going to go up top here for just to find that center. Actually, I have to come off that edge there, so I have to change datum around here. Now, there is a mark to mark what datum you're using, but that might be too complicated just for now to do it. It is actually using that feature there. So if I clicked on it and I put that, just says somewhere I've actually clicked already. So if I just go to datum feature, click on that there, I can then do that there. Okay, it's getting a little bit messy, but on that. So that's a datum mark. For that, so that gives you the centers. That gives you the centers of those there, and also gives you the distance between that there. Now, in terms of the depth of that hole, it actually goes to that point there. So I'm actually going to put in a dimension from that still datum line to that mark there. Okay, and I'll bring that over to there. That's fine. And I should actually do that there, because that actually is a cutout. So if I go from there up to that there, and I'll come on this side, I need that there, so I need to move this one out a bit more. Okay, and then bring that one in down to about there. Okay, now I'm going to put another center mark in, just seeing it, do that one there. That's fine. That's fine. That's good enough for me at the moment. It's just this markings here now that I need to do. So off the center mark, I've just got to remember what I'm doing here. So let's go smart dimension. Okay, let's do an overall from there to there. Oh, we've got that upstairs, haven't we? So I don't actually need to do that, but what I am going to do is the actual wall thickness. So I'm going to go from there to there. Mark that there, and I shall do the same from there to there. Okay, and I'll do the same from there to there. That's 0.8. Just make it nice and clear if I can. A bit close to that tolerancing box, so I can move everything about, and I'll do the same from there to there. Arthur! From there. Okay, now there is a wall thickness here, and when you make that as a shelled part, I can, if you want to look at it, I could have actually done that on here, but just to show you a little bit of dimensioning on that, I can actually do the same part on there and there. Just bring that in there, not quite right. Just put a radius mark in there, down to there. If I press escape button, just bring that down and just drop it down so it's a lot clearer. And in my notes, I'd put nominal wall thickness mark unless otherwise stated. So that really is the basics of doing a component drawing. Now the only other thing is marking up the pages. The easiest way to do it, there's several ways, and this is the way I've always done it, but in the drawing number, okay, that is, if I just come out of that for a second, okay, if I just right hand click and then go edit sheet format, you'll see that there, just double click on it, and if you go to the font, it then actually gets that down to something like, let's go down to 10, so it actually fits nicely in that there. Now you can go to note and actually add text in, just click, sorry, that's I'll come out of that sheet format, so just press escape or double click on the sorry, up here, little box. What I can do is where I've got notes at the moment, you'll see from my previous thing, I'm actually using a leader on there. So if I just go to this box here and take the leader off and just click on a note anywhere, so I can just type in Arthur. I'm not typing in Arthur, so that's there, and it takes my last one, so I can drop that anywhere. I could put my scale in, I can talk about material. So if I do another one in here, just go back to note in there and just put something like ABS, okay, and then fill in the rest of the stuff here and change what I need to do. So that is the basics of a component drawing. Just make sure you've got clear and concise measurements and you start from one end, your datum points, that's your zero point, and actually mark up bits and pieces. You will also need on here is to put in either well, not for this, but a general arrangement, you can put a parts list in. I tend to do this, I can underline and then I go number one, all tolerances 0.02, and I put a plus and a minus in, so plus slash minus, and then unless otherwise stated, and again, automatic number two. My last one I always put in, let's put something else in, all radius. Or radii 0.2, unless otherwise stated, and then number three, if in doubt, ask. There's a whole lot more I should add to that list, but for what you require at the moment, that is fine. On my sheet, I have my logo up here and date number, but for now that is probably sufficient for you. Any problems, just ask.